Once upon a mattress. Recording day 3664, and the take is 1.
Carol Burnett in Once Upon a Mattress, brought to you by Lipton Tea. We're delighted to have you with us for another Lipton Tea special program, starring Miss Carol Burnett. Good evening. I'm George Fenneman. Tonight you'll see Daring Do in a royal castle, and through here, my castle. Come on. Solid stucco. It's spear-proof. And complete with modern knights of the office and ladies of the supermarket and a round table. Here's Herb, the harried. He needs a change.
What a day. Meetings, traffic, rushing, coffee. 5 cups of coffee.
Did you say coffee?
Me? No thanks. I'd sooner Lipton.
Brisk Lipton tea. Refreshment fit for a king. It's the change of pace drink. All the satisfaction of coffee, but even more refreshing. That brisk flavor gives you a friendlier lift, that Lipton lift. Only Lipton blends brisk with its choice orange Pekoe tea and brews brisk in the Lipton flow-through tea bag with 4 sides. So it refreshes brisk, too. Enjoy a change of pace from the coffee race. Fill your tankard with a cup with the change of pace drink, brisk Lipton tea. And now, Once Upon a Mattress, starring Carol Burnett.
You've probably all heard the fanciful tale about the princess who was so sensitive that she felt a pea under 20 mattresses. Well, I can tell you the true story of the princess and the pea for the very good reason that I was there, serving as minstrel at the court where it all took place. The princess in the true story was not the only girl put to the test to prove her royalty. There were many others, all brought in from neighboring kingdoms and given impossible tests thought up by the queen and her confidant, the wizard. This was princess number 12.
Would you repeat that last question, please?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the second cousin once removed of the blacksmith who forged the sword Excalibur? You have 10 seconds.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Bad, my dear. Blood will tell, but yours didn't tell us quite enough.
The thoughtful queen always gave a consolation prize.
Goodbye. Good luck and get out. Oh, you see, sweetheart, she wasn't a real princess.
Poor Prince Dauntless. I fear in this drama he rarely says more than...
Yes, Mama.
The court was disturbed when the prospect was nixed, but the ladies were positive.
That test was fixed.
Cheer up, ladies. I have a new trick. Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment, no folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
We know your trick. That test wasn't fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
The queen had passed a law which said,
throughout the land, no one may wed till Dauntless shares his marriage bed.
This ridiculous law I had boldly defied and had secretly made Lady Larkin my bride. I told one good friend of my marriage, of course. His reaction was,
why don't you get a divorce?
The jester loved her too. He pours out his heart to his good friend, the king, who responds with a look, for he can't say a thing. His majesty was mute. As for Her Majesty, the Queen herself will now advance, and we shall see who wears the royal pants.
Come along, sweetheart. Don't dawdle. Pick up your feet, precious. Angel, don't squint. How many times have I told you not to look at the sun?
Ow! Oh!
Sextimus! If I've told you once, I've told you 100,000 times, I will not have you playing these foolish games and running around in the halls. It simply is not dignified. We are the rulers of this kingdom, and if we don't set a proper example for the rest of the court, I'd like to know who will. I mean, what is the point of being a ruler if one is not going to behave as a ruler should?
Mama?
Yes, pussycat?
Mama? When am I going to get my princess?
Dauntless, I don't want to discuss that now. It's time for your cocoa.
But, Mama, sometimes I get the funniest feeling that you don't want me to get married.
Don't want you to get married? Don't want you to get married? Dauntless, don't you trust me?
Oh, of course, Mama.
Well, how can you say such a thing? I want you to get married. How many times have I said to you, I want you to get married? Why, only this morning I was saying to your father, I said, Sextimus, I want that boy to get married. It simply is not normal for a boy his age to stay single. And after all, he's the prince, I said, don't forget that. He's next in line to the throne. I mean, we may not be the oldest people in the kingdom, but on the other hand, we are not going to live forever. And I just know that I'd feel much better, much easier and more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married and settled and set. And that is absolutely verbatim exactly what I said to your father this morning. Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But then you know him as well as I do. I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. Well, that's my cross of pain. And I don't want you to worry your head one little bit about the fact that your father and I don't get along and never have. If he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, well, I'll just have to put up with it. And I will not allow it to affect my child's attitude toward him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, dreadful, selfish, rotten man, but he is your father. And I want you to respect him. Oh, there is only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your health and your happiness and your future. And that's what I'm talking about right now, your future. You are a prince, and you must marry someone suitable, someone who's good enough and fine enough and smart enough for my good, nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And she must be a princess. I mean, a real princess. That's one thing I absolutely insist upon. She has to be a real, genuine, bona fide princess, just as I was. Oh, that's what you really want, isn't it, darling? Someone like me. Of course you do. Oh, if I were only 20 years younger. Well, just remember this. You may roam the whole world over, but you'll never find another, be it ever so humble. There's no place like your mother.
For many weeks, the court had to listen to this monologue. As winter turned into spring, the lords and ladies of the court all but gave up hope that a true princess of the royal blood would ever be found for Dauntless. And then, one sunny morning in mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot the meadows, the lookout in the North Round Tower thought he saw a figure in the distance approaching on foot.
What is it?
It's a girl!
Or something!
And the word was spread. Now let's see, how did that part go in the old story? On a stormy night to the castle door came the lass the prince had been waiting for. That, of course, is utterly untrue. It didn't storm that night at all. In fact, it wasn't even night, and the princess only looked as if she'd come in from a storm.
She wouldn't wait for the drawbridge.
You swam the moat.
Uh-huh. She seemed determined to arrive as soon as possible. We had to get a rope and pull her out.
You swam the moat. Well, all right, I was a little anxious. But I heard you had an opening for a princess. Any princess. I figured the early bird.
No!
Anyway, here I am.
Who's the lucky man? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani, 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 no.
Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani, 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 no.
Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Or you, or you, or you, or...
Nani, noni, nini, nani, no, no.
No! Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be. Not with me, can't you see? That I am just as embarrassed as you. And I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy. I confess that I'm shy. Can't you guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear 'cause I'm shy? And you may be sure, way down deep I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it, at bottom I'm quiet and pure. I'm aware that it's wrong to be meek as I am. My chances may pass me by, I pretend to be strong. Terribly timid and horribly. Though a lady may be dripping with glamour, as often as not, she will stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. And she's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a pair of pants. Quite often the lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams.
Do you ever say anything
else?
Do you
expect me to believe that you are a true princess of the royal blood?
Yes.
And am I actually to understand that you have the nerve and the gall and the presumption to apply for my son's hand in marriage?
Mama, may I say something?
No. Do you imagine for one moment that I would even find you suitable for any son of mine, huh? Well, you are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. No son of mine is ever going to marry any... moat swimmer. Not while I have a breath left in my body. And I haven't been well. Not well at all. I get these shooting pains all in through here. And don't try and tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I've had the vapors.
Are you new here?
Yes.
Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment. No,
it's a nut house.
Oh, please, Dave, please.
No, wait.
You're the one, I guess, huh?
Sure. I'm Prince Dauntless, the drab.
Glad to have met you.
Oh, no, please don't go. I like you.
Everybody does.
Ha!
Almost everybody.
Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother.
Oh, but I really like you. I really like her, Mama. Can I marry her? Can I?
Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry a real princess.
I am a real princess.
I'm sure she's a princess.
She must be a princess.
Thanks, girl.
At least the test, Your Majesty.
At least a test, not for me, Mama, please.
Oh, all right, we'll test her.
Hooray!
The wizard and I will put on our thinking caps and make up a nice fair test, just as we always do. And she'll fail just like all the others, fair and square.
Test what? What test?
The royalty test.
Well, every princess suing for my hand must pass a test to prove she's a real princess.
What kind of test?
It's always highly secret.
Oh. Well, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I'd better get out of these wet clothes.
May I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
There goes Princess number 13.
This is our last chance.
If she doesn't pass the test, I'm going to kill myself.
You're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
You're good looking, too.
You're better looking and nicer, too.
Well, you're a better swimmer.
It's a royal welcome for the princess, even if she did have to swim the moat. But in modern times, things aren't easy either. Watch. Meet photographer Bill. He races for coffee. Snaps pictures. More coffee. More pictures. Coffee again. He needs a change of pace.
Coffee? Hey, wait. I'd sooner Lipton.
You've said the magic word. Brisk Lipton tea. It's the change of pace drink. Satisfies like coffee, but refreshes you better. It's one tea that's different. Better blend with its choice orange pekoe tea. Better tea bag with not just two, but four brewing signs. The Lipton flow through tea bag. Brews brisk, different from the usual tea. Lipton satisfies like coffee.
But refreshes you better.
That's why I'd sooner Lipton.
When you need a break from the coffee race, enjoy this, the change of pace drink. Brisk Lipton tea.
12 princesses, 12 tests, 12 failures. The ladies of the court had little hope that princess number 13 would be any different. Unlucky ladies.
Yes, a safe spinster's life for them.
Why, you don't miss it, do you?
Oh, heavens, no. But I do worry about what will happen to us if the Queen finds out that we broke the law and are secretly married.
She won't find out.
I'm not so sure. Do you remember the royal joust on Whit Sunday last?
Certainly.
And do you remember the picnic we all had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes, of course.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down.
Yes.
And then we watched the sun go down.
Yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby.
Well, that's marvelous.
So you see, she's going to find out quite soon.
Well, that's very simple. We'll go away.
But the Queen would never allow that, and the palace is heavily guarded.
Well, that's a detail.
Well, even if we could escape, where could we go?
Over the wall. Over the hills and down to the sea, where a ship will be waiting.
And then?
Normandy. So Normandy is where we'll go. I can show you a beach where the peach blossom blows, and I know how to reach a man who knows a man who knows a cozy inn, a friendly place with rows of windows facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm in Normandy. I know a meadow covered with mustard flowers, golden as the sun, where a wondrous thing can happen when an April day is done. There's a moment after the twilight when the sky is suddenly green and the world stands hushed and waiting for the first white stars to convene. When you've seen that emerald sky, you'll know the reason why. There's not another place for us to be. Don't be afraid, my darling. Sigh no more, for I adore you.
Across the sea,
come fly
I'll
with
fly
me.
With you.
Come slip
I
away.
Know
have things to do.
Is there truly a beach where the peach blossom blows? Are you sure you can reach that man who knows that man who knows that cozy inn?
There's jessamine. White lilac
lace
facing the sea.
This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm.
Don't be afraid.
A love is made in Normandy.
There she is, Your Majesty. Come and get her. Why not? But you've been chasing this one for 2 years. Let her go. Go ahead. I don't know why I try to help you when you won't even help yourself. Minstrel, I give your marriage 1 week, and after that...
What is it, sire? You want me to sing a song for you? What kind of song? A funny song? About what? The Queen? Again? I have the feeling that you don't care for the Queen. Oh, the Queen is quite often in bed, racked with pain from her heel to her head. For such illness, I'm sure there is only one cure: to get up and go out and drop dead. If Her Majesty takes my advice, she will cheer up the court of its rights. But she'll doubly delight every lady and knight if she does it upright and drops dead twice.
Out.
Your Majesty.
You are banished from my court and from this kingdom forever. I'll see you never work again.
Now, Your Majesty, please.
Out of the castle by sunset.
But...
Out, out, out! I never liked him anyway. He wouldn't play in my key. Now, oh, I am in no mood to spend hours racking my brains over a test for that girl when I've got aches here and here and a strange nagging pain in my jaw. How would you describe her?
Crude.
Oh, well then, we'll test her for sensitivity. Oh, yes, she'll have her test. Oh, the worst of it is that foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a test that looks fair, and sounds fair, and seems fair, and isn't fair. But what?
Table manners?
Oh, that's not good enough. Sensitivity. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet. This is the blessing, also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is. Suffered by gentle people like me.
Aww.
Get your hands off me, think of a tricky test. Well, I'm wretched boat-swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest? Maybe we ought to...
Don't take all night, I'm not well, I need my rest. Not that I ever sleep on that lumpy mattress, egad my back. Sensitivity, bane of royalty, that bed's a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump even if it were under the mattress and small as a pea. That's the answer! Under the mattress! We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick downy mattress, that suits your bright. Any genuine princess would feel it if she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest bee and order one mattress. No, make it two.
Why not five?
10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps, we'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning. But you're devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive, she'll fall asleep, no doubt. My, but you're clever, brilliant, a genius. You are divine. Get out.
Winifred is in for a surprise. And we get surprises here, too, it seems. You, sir, must be a noted herald.
Noted? I'm noted for my flat notes.
Too many fanfares, huh?
Too many coffees. Two tournaments, two coffees. A royal procession, more coffee. A fiery dragon, more coffee.
And now your dragon.
I need a change.
And I've got it. The change of pace drink. Brisk Lipton tea. Notice how it satisfies like coffee, but Lipton refreshes you better. It's the one tea that's brisk, because only Lipton blends brisk with its choice orange pekoe tea and brews brisk in the Lipton flow-through tea bag with not just two, but four brewing sides.
You're right. I'd sooner Lipton.
A welcome change of pace from the coffee race. It's the change of pace drink.
That's it.
Lift your family's spirits with brisk Lipton tea. Now, Carol Burnett in Once Upon a Mattress.
Dauntless was beside himself. By now it was clear to everyone that he had lost his heart completely. As for the princess, she was doing her best to make the adjustment to dry land.
Well, it certainly feels good to get into something dry. This old dress is just soaked.
Your Highness, excuse me, but the King has asked to meet the young lady.
Why? He's never asked before.
He heard she swam the moat.
Is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is...
Oh, no, my papa is silent.
Oh, I'd love to meet him.
Papa?
This is Princess Winifred.
Your Highness, the King welcomes you.
Oh.
Oh, my father never touches his crown to his heart unless he really means it.
The King is mute, or he would speak for himself. He is still under a curse cast by a witch long ago, before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says...
King Sextimus will never...